sunrise. Sprinkle it with dew. Cover it in chocolate and a miracle or two. The Candyman. The Candyman can. Candyman can. Plus he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good.
Hey guys, it's Mason.
And Daria.
And we're MDtv, behind the scenes. And we're here at Edelweiss Chocolate Factory in Beverly Hills, California.
Because who doesn't like chocolate?
Who doesn't? You recognize it? That's because Lucille Ball got her inspiration for the famous chocolate scene here. So, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, absolutely. So, this is Edelweiss Chocolates. My family owns and operates the business. We've been the owners for about the last 15 years. We're the fifth owners. The business was started in 1942 by Mrs. Grace Young. The original name of the business was Candy Roundup. It actually started off as more of a local candy shop where Mrs. Grace actually sold her exclusive line of marshmallows. At that point, the marshmallows were something, they still are, but at that point especially, they were very unique. Not very many people at all had had a traditional marshmallow here in the U.S. So she started with that. She owned the business for about 30 years. And then after that, Mr. Herman, an Austrian gentleman, bought the business and changed the name to Edelweiss, and he brought his Swiss recipes with him. After Mr. Herman, Sam and Mrs. Rosen owned the business for about 18 years. And then the famous Shirley Jones, she was on the Partridge family, she owned the business for about 5 years. And then we purchased it from them.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, so I know you have some celebrity clients. Can you tell us who those are?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we'd have to shoot for a couple days for me to get through all of them. But a few notables, past and present. Let's start with
all
the
right,
old ones. So, Katharine Hepburn wrote about us in her autobiography. She used to buy our dark chocolate turtles. It's caramel and walnuts, shaped kind of like a turtle, and then covered in dark chocolate.
Yeah.
Frank Sinatra used to buy the maple pecan creams. Yeah, these are really, really good. His wife and daughter, Nancy and Barbara, still buy them to this day. So these were Frank Sinatra's favorites. And current celebrity clients, Oprah buys our Oreos. She loves our Oreo cookies, especially on Valentine's. She buys a giant 8-pound heart filled with the Oreos for her production company.
Those sound really good.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
No, they're awesome. Yeah, I think what a gift. And then Madonna buys our plain vanilla marshmallows, especially when she's touring. She buys a very, very large quantity for her staff, and she takes them on tour with her. So those are Madonna's favorite.
Wow, that sounds good.
And if you look at all of the chocolates, you can see the designs on top of them. Each one is done by hand. So the M is marked by hand, and the X on top of the marshmallow. Each one has its own. Either they're marked by hand, or there's some kind of a stamp that goes on them by hand, or there's an inclusion like sprinkles or nuts that goes on top of them.
Yeah.
So each one has its own unique look. So this is our kitchen, and this is where we make all of the fillings for our confections and our chocolates, like our truffles, the ganache that goes in there, the honeycomb, the molasses. So I just wanted to show you some of our equipment. This is our caramel and toffee machine right here. This is almost 100 years old. It's from 1918. Yeah, in about 4 years, it's going to be 100 years old. It's from Chicago, from the Savage Brothers Company. They are still a company that makes candy making equipment, but all of their equipment now is very automated. It's all, you know, like it's got computer systems attached to it. They don't make these mechanical machines anymore. We have a philosophy here at Edelweiss where we repair rather than replace. We really take a lot of pride
That's
in
a good
what we
philosophy.
Have.
Yeah.
Exactly, right?
Why waste money when you can...
You know what? Oddly enough, it's actually more expensive and time-consuming
to keep
the old equipment than to replace it, specifically because we have to find people who... Very specialized people to help fix the equipment.
What training or experience do you need to become a chocolatier?
You know what? There's a lot of training that goes involved in what we do here because it's very specialized. It's an art form. Specifically, the dipping and the design work that goes onto the chocolates, that takes a long time. It takes about a little over a year, I would say, to learn how to do it.
Yeah.
And even then, to perfect it, it takes longer than that.
You would think it would just be like, but no, it seems really, really complex.
It's all extremely, exactly. It's very intricate. Like, for instance, I'll walk you through one of the steps.
Right.
We have our Bordeaux cream here. We basically make the Bordeaux cream, and then we take the cream and roll it by hand,
one by one. Yeah.
And then the cream gets thrown into the chocolate, and then by hand we pull it out, and then we'll put it right here. We have these, I don't know, it's website. We have a tray filled with sprinkles, and then while the chocolate is wet, we'll drop the cream with the chocolate filling, I mean the chocolate with the cream filling
onto the sprinkles.
Yeah, and then when we take them off and they're dry, we have this really pretty sprinkle design on the bottom.
Wow, that's
cool. Yeah, and then it has, after we put them in the sprinkles, there's a little swirl design that goes on top of it. So
and they all hand do that. They all do the little swirl.
Yeah, everything is done
by hand. Yeah.
Wow. And we have trays and trays of them here that we're making.
That's so rare.
Yeah, absolutely.
Amazing.
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of hard work, but yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Do you have any parties or events?
Yeah, we do actually. We have about 60 elementary schools that come in on a yearly basis. They bring their students here, anywhere from ages 7 till about 11. So we do tours for them. We do a lot of private tours. We do a lot of public tours. We're very proud of our facilities and our history, so we're more than happy to do tours all the time. We also do birthday parties and private events where
it's a lot of fun.
We'll up to a group of about 20 people. We'll teach you how to do our hand dipping, like Oreos and graham crackers and pretzels, how to do the design work on top of it, and how to make molded items, like molded champagne bottles or butterflies.
Oh, I saw those up there.
Yeah, wow, yeah. So we've got about 1,000 different molds to choose from that we do. Yeah, all different types of them.
It's a wide variety.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Yeah. The kids really love it.
All right, well, thank you so much.
Sure, well, I have a couple pieces of chocolate for you guys to try since you seem to like our classic chocolates. Here's Catherine Hepburn's favorite and Frank Sinatra's favorite for you.
It's got an M on it.
It's perfect.
Perfect. All right, here we go. I'm going to try and do this with the microphone in my hand.
Okay.
I might.
Okay, go.
Isn't that good?
That's delicious. That is so good. Thank you.
Yeah, anytime. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you for having us.
Anytime.
I'm Mason. And I'm Daria.
We're MDtv, taking you to the other side.
What's going on over here? You guys are... You're not supposed to eat them!